The island of Bermuda is 21 square miles of paradise located in the Atlantic Ocean. Its crystal clear blue waters and extensive coral reef system are just a few of the island's natural gems that draw thousands of visitors to its shores each year. However, for an island so welcoming, there is one guest that local residents have not been able to embrace with open arms, and that is the invasive lionfish. With 18 venomous spines, a never-ending appetite, and no natural predators, lionfish are an extreme threat to Bermuda's marine ecosystem. Experts believe that the first lionfish to have been spotted in Bermuda was in 1999. But how exactly did these toxic invaders end up here? My initial research revealed that lionfish are native to the Indo-Pacific. They are believed to have been released into the Atlantic in the late 1980s by fish hobbyists or local aquariums in Florida. The species spread like wildfire throughout the Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico because of their fast reproduction rates. Female lionfish can spawn over 2 million eggs per year. To understand why lionfish pose such a great threat to Bermuda's ocean and coral reef system, I went straight to the experts.
The reason invasive lionfish are so potentially problematic is that they just eat everything. They don't really have any mechanism to stop feeding, and they just eat and eat and eat, and they completely gorge themselves.
What knock-on effects do their large appetites have on native reef species?
They are inevitably taking important species that have some sort of role to play in the environment. They could be eating, for example, juvenile parrotfish. And we know that juvenile parrotfish eat the algae, which then allows the coral to grow healthy. If the algae runs wild, if it grows out of control, it smothers the coral reef. The coral reef can't get sunlight, can't exchange oxygen and nutrients from the water, and ultimately dies. So through direct predation and indirectly through competition, they're just this spanner in the works of a healthy coral reef system.
Although lionfish were first reported in Bermuda in the early 2000s, it wasn't until 2012 when populations began to rise that the government, along with other ocean-related stakeholders, devised a master plan to tackle the invasion. From this, the Lionfish Task Force was born, a coalition of members who are dedicated to the fight against lionfish through research and education. One solution to the invasion that has proven popular amongst the diving community is spear hunting. The Bermuda government invites residents to obtain special calling permits to hunt lionfish. With the permit, however, also comes a responsibility to report your catch to the Ocean Support Foundation. This allows researchers to track the distribution and abundance of lionfish on the island. It also helps culers find hotspots where they are most likely to find their catch. Some of Bermuda's leading ocean heroes have even noticed a seasonal trend in the number of lionfish that can be found year-round, as well as other tactical hunting patterns that they can utilize to their advantage.
Now, it hasn't been scientifically proven, but what we recognize is that during the colder months of the year, lionfish migrate into the shallow water, where they're easier to be caught and culled. And then during the summer months, when the sea surface temperature warms, we find that lionfish are a bit more difficult to catch in mass because they tend to have fled into deeper water.
Is there a certain time of day when you're more likely to catch lionfish?
We know if you and I were to go on a dive during the day, mostly I'd say 8 out of 10 lionfish that we would catch would be what we call hold up. You know, they tend not to like the sunlight too much, and they'll hole up and come out to feed at night. Would you say lionfish are nocturnal? No, I wouldn't say lionfish were nocturnal. We will find some of them out during the day and kind of hovering on top of the reef ominously. But most of the time, if we needed to get out there and catch high numbers in Bermuda, we will go out at dusk and dawn, start of the day or the end of the day, and maybe even at night.
Some people have labeled lionfish a super predator. Do you agree with this statement?
They occupy the entire water column from 4 inches of water, you know, to 1,000 feet of water. And I hear in their invaded range, you know, there's the prey naivety, right? Like the small fish and invertebrates don't recognize a lionfish as a predator. I would say, yeah, without question, the lionfish is definitely a super predator.
So far, nearly 2,000 people have taken the culling course to obtain their hunting permits. According to the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, over 3,000 lionfish were culled in just the last permitting period.
We are very lucky in Bermuda to have this fantastic community of lionfish hunters. You know, these people are dedicated. They understand not just the impact lionfish could have on the local environment, but they understand that it's delicious. So they're not just in the water protecting the reef, they're also in the water getting a free meal and a very delicious and a very nutritious meal at the same time.
Despite having venomous spines, lionfish are full of healthy omega-3 fatty acids and have very low levels of mercury compared to other fish, which makes hunting them even more desirable. For some of Bermuda's active cullers, the government has issued special vendor permits to them so that they have the option to commercially sell their catch. One of the island's luxury resorts, the Lauren, has been embracing the opportunity to buy sustainably from local cullers and feature lionfish regularly on their menu.
Awareness to it came by going into the local hardware store. I forget what the local hardware store, I think it's like a True Value. And they had this on the monitor, a little, you know, blurb about it and a little short program. And I was captivated just watching it and seeing how many lionfish were out there, how it had expanded. And when you think about, you know, other fish that we've overfished, you know, that we put in danger, and then you have this fish that it would be better if we fished it more. It became, it was bizarre to me that no one had been doing more of putting it on the menu here. I think we were the first one to consistently have it on our menu and to where people started to respond. And it's one of our featured dishes. We've developed a lot of great relationships with local fishermen, right? The lionfish that we have on our menu, more than likely it was swimming in the water less than 24 hours ago. Most of the time, I would say a majority of the time, the fishermen will bring in the fish and that fish will be used that evening.
As the commercial market for lionfish continues to grow on island, the chef hopes the government will issue even more vendor permits to individuals looking to work in a sustainable fishing environment.
I would like to see it become a little bit easier for more individuals to get their lionfish hunting license, their spearfishing license, and I think that would make it more advantageous. I also think that, you know, again, not saying anything bad about government, but I think if we kind of bent the rules a little bit and allowed people to sell without having commercial licenses, that you'd find more people out there hunting the fish and selling directly to restaurants and or supermarkets and or eating for themselves. There is a skill set to it. Obviously, you have to clean it. They're not poisonous, they're venomous, so they have venom in their, in the spiny parts of their body. So it's not something that just any amateur can go out and do. We need to educate and teach the young fishermen how to go out and how to catch and then harvest these fish and get it to chefs like me to put it on a plate.
Looking into Bermuda's future, it appears that lionfish might become a permanent option on many restaurant menus across the island. Researchers have warned that the invasive lionfish will be a threat that Bermuda will have to mitigate indefinitely. However, the country might have an upper hand, and that is due to the fact that their lionfish population has grown very slowly compared to other affected regions.
It hasn't quite reached the tipping point. It hasn't become nearly as bad as we might have feared in the early days, but that's not to say it isn't still growing. It might not get worse and worse and worse.
What do you think the health of Bermuda's coral reefs will be in the next 10 to 15 years?
In 10 or 15 years, I just can only hope that we don't see these huge impacts, but it's really just hard to tell. We haven't seen that population explosion. We worry it's coming. Maybe it doesn't. Maybe there's enough about their biology and their ecology and Bermuda's placement in the Middle Atlantic that sort of prevents the lionfish from ever becoming this super abundant, negatively impacting species.
As Bermuda continues to battle its lionfish invasion, there's a lack of data to suggest what long-term impacts lionfish will have on the marine environment here and related industries. But the one thing that is certain is that there is a large community of local cullers here who are on the front lines so that more lionfish end up on dinner plates instead of taking up residence in Bermuda's coral reefs.